This movie tells a story about Greville Wynne, a British engineer and businessman who was recruited by MI6 because of his frequent travel to Eastern Europe. He becomes a courier to transport top secret information to London from Soviet agent Oleg Penkovsky to put an end to the Cuban Missile Crisis. First of all, this movie is dull and does little to make Wynne the larger-than-life figure needed to tell this otherwise familiar tale of espionage. Though its tale of espionage and international intrigue is based on a true story, this movie is less interested in exploring the complex realities of the Cold War than in repeating some of the more tired artistic tropes about the era. Much of this plodding film feels as if it's been cribbed from other, more potent works about shadowy Soviet-era intelligence. It's not clear what the audience is supposed to make of Wynne, and that's ultimately the film's biggest flaw. The script prefers to tell us things about Wynne rather than show. The amateur spy is trained by MI6 and CIA handlers Dickie Franks and Emily Donovan, but it mostly amounts to dull conversations about what not to do. The real-life Wynne insisted he had actually been recruited back during World War II, something the film should address or incorporate it head-on. It's also suggested that Wynne is a bit of a ladies' man with a partying lifestyle, but other than one scene he shares with Penkovsky, he never comes across as anything more than a boring suit and tie guy. Benedict Cumberbatch's understated button-up performance doing him little favors in the charisma department. Wynne simply is not that interesting on his own and still comes across as bland. He doesn't seem to be particularly patriotic or especially close to his family. The result is an ill-defined and contradictory protagonist whose lack of strong personal qualities might make him an effective spy, but it doesn't make him an especially compelling one. By comparison, there's depthness to the way the film parallels the burgeoning friendship between Wynne and Penkovsky, with the strain that Wynne's secret life increasingly places on his marriage, as his wife begins to suspect that her husband's mysterious trips to Moscow may be cover for an affair. But even as both relationships come under increasing threat from the Soviets, who begin to suspect a traitor in their ranks, the movie does little to ramp up the tension on either a personal or a geopolitical level. Additionally, there's a whole lot of problems with the third act, which starts off escalating the proceedings into a tense undercover escape that goes haywire. The script slides into what feels like a different story, deserving of its own movie or at least more time given to it than what's shown here. There's forced emotional payoffs that would work if they didn't come so soon. It would also play better if Penkovsky and his family weren't just sidelined after the most dramatic sequence in the film. As the Cuban Missile Crisis really kicks into gear, the film starts to suffer an identity crisis with a rushed and cloying finale. Overall, the movie is a disappointment.